Welcome to the August 13th edition of Sports on the Afternoons with MATK17, Aaron Channel. I tell you, it's been wild. Crazy 24 hours. I got on and stuff going on in real life. They're really just crazy. I'm not gonna really end up with. You know, I thought, you know, we could possibly skip over stuff in this game's like, nope. You have to. You have to play games. That's right, you have to continue to play games. Just for the fuck of it. You don't want to. I guess I can skip out of them, but I mean, just waste time. Let's play the next whatever levels in real life there were this past season. Next one really bad.
It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
They're a mess. They're a mess for a long time.
2K Sports. Ernie Johnson here. Welcome everybody. We have the great Shaquille O'Neal. And the equally great.
I play Isaiah Thomas, they put him in this mess, taking all these deals and trades and all this stuff, and then everybody else has been trying to fix the team since.
The results have been excellent for them over the first half of the season. And it has to be said, they're not showing any signs of slowing down anytime soon. And Shaq, we're coming up to the halfway point of the season. Some teams.
There's so many, so much messes.
Like,
I mean, and then they didn't have any draft picks, first round draft picks for like year, how many years? Yeah, it's put you in a mess because then you only have any picks to
quality veterans
help your team in the future. And they pick dumb players anyway. They do have draft picks.
Better time of year than the holidays for NBA basketball on 2K Sports. Welcome everyone. I'm Kevin Harlan along with Greg Anthony and Doris Burke. Our sideline reporter tonight is David Aldrin. Look at Orlando. With most of their upcoming games taking place at home, they have a chance here to make a nice little push.
Nice to play your home right around the holidays.
But the level of competition won't be.
Point of the season, game starting to add up now, Doris. How do the players keep the mental side of their game sharp and efficient?
I think the veterans have always told me, Kevin, that part of that is you just get in a rhythm and a routine. So if you're on the road, you do a certain time of
day. Egg.
On the first bus, the second bus, there's a real rhythm and routine in making sure you're staying sharp.
So routine brings sharpness. Is that what you're saying?
I would say that that's a big part of it.
Big part. All fueled up and ready to go. Brought to you by Gatorade. Let's check out who's on the floor. On the court for Orlando, Ibaka is the forward. Vucevic in the middle. Fournier out there with Young. And it's Prince in at the threesome.
Damn it.
And he comes up with the deuce.
And the ability to generate points off offensive rebounds.
Nice rebound, Ted.
His career before he started spending so much time on the perimeter.
It's stolen by Vucevic. And here we go with the magic pass break. Young passes to Prez. He kicks it to Vucevic.
And passes it back to Young. He's out of bounds.
Screen by Ibaka. Now the pass to Prez. Four on the clock.
Ugh.
But clear breakdown on defense. They're unfortunate that he didn't make them pay.
Lee kicks to Rose. New York moving the ball around. Anthony's shot is off.
He has the skills to finish that. I cannot believe he blew it.
Rez dishes to Young. Now here's Prez, covered by Anthony.
That was Woo!
You can knock those down if you give
him. Got a wide open there in the corner.
The first chance they've had to see Orlando.
Yeah, and they lost the season series to this squad last time around. Maybe a little extra motivation tonight to show they've improved.
Passes to Noah. The shot, no good. And Orlando the other way now. They're moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of Miami.
And I really felt in watching that game that they needed to abandon the 3-point.
I guess you think it, you know, they thought going into the season next they're going to do better and picked up Jackie Noah, Derrick Rose. Yeah, that didn't hit the presses. Didn't last long.
From the line this time.
Our season.
No
way at all. Season Rose continues to be whatever the hell. He's never really recovered from his knee problems. Anyway, sometimes it's been good, but just, he's like, I think he's probably, he plays when he is on the ground, he's not hurt, he plays tentative because he's always hurt. He always gets hurt, it seems like. So when he does play, he feels like you can see sometimes he'll play tentative on the court. And now he's going to play with the Cavs next year. But I think the rumor is he's going to sign with them. I don't know if he is, but.
This is it to Noah. Vucevic with the block.
Yeah, I had to pass there because he was going to knock me out of bounds. So it worked out.
Possession.
And I felt the AI afterwards and almost threw it out of bounds. Got out of bounds.
Now about 3 minutes gone in the first quarter. Young dishes to Prez. Fournier in the corner. From the arc.
You can never discount the range and the wingspan that Melo brings. He can bother a lot of shots.
Rose passes to Porzingis. No good from outside.
Almost seemed like he was overthinking that shot. Such a wide open look.
Now let's find out what head coach Jeff Hornacek had to say to David Aldridge, DA.
Well, Kevin, he expects their interior defense to be airtight. He said rim protection is something we really do well.
Yeah.
Contest shots allows us to become more aggressive on the perimeter. Makes it a win-win. We'll see if all of that holds up for them tonight. Back to you.
Okay, Dave, thanks. That's a mantra.
Again, it's coasting.
You know, we always do, but it really
oh, crap.
With this group, when they
no, the ball should have went past them. These arms are fucking Mr. Stretchy arms. Alright, does that work that way?
One guy is off, the defense crumbles.
All the officials are all over that one.
You know, what's interesting about Porzingis is...
Both. Think to me
career, no question. But he had a very good grasp of the culture when he came over, and he loves the American lifestyle. He's got the slang down. He's a very outgoing guy.
Prez gets to Biombo.
And then pass it to the fucking inside. Pass it to the outside. You passed it to the wrong guy. What the fuck are you smoking in? I didn't pass it to that guy. I'm pushing out in the direction you're passing it to.
Teams are making sure that they have two players that can hurt you from outside at all times. And for this team, those players are present young.
Orlando with the ball. Here's Prez. It's rebounded by Prez.
What the fuck? Bullshit. Come on, game. That should have been fucking in.
Can just be an added task, but for Porzingis.
What the fuck?
I just love how Porzingis...
There's some fucking team there.
What the fans want to hear. There's a confidence and a brashness that he plays with that quickly had fans flocking to him. You know, he's got the perfect personality and embraces the culture of sport. So it's hard to think that he...
Yeah. I finally let a ball go in the basket to fucking team me. Yeah, goaltending. It's legal.
Young against Rose. Ball's knocked loose. Here's the shooter. That time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
You know, Kristaps Porzingis is an impressive athlete. With
against the NBA rules. Goaltending is against the rules of the NBA. So, every day I'm doing it.
And good on a second, so he makes them both. And you heard some in the Knicks front office say that Porzingis might actually be too tall in the NBA game. How often, Doris, you hear that?
No, for sure. I mean, there were some who wondered if his core strength might never enable him.
What the fuck?
But you know the Zen Master. Come on. I think that was
close. I feel like that's on me, but what the fuck?
Setting out the challenge and making...
I don't see where that was. That was just a bullshit call there.
And here is Lee. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Outside, Porzingis. New York moving the ball around. The wide open look here for Anthony. And the go-ahead bucket, no good. Prez kicks to Biombo. There's the dish to Young. Passes it to Prez. From beyond the arc. Nice.
Yeah. Yo, Jay, baby.
Young knew to try and find space outside when Prez got the ball. Great sequence there from Orange Juice.
Knicks trail by four. Rose dishes to Anthony. Porzingis sets the pick for Anthony. As New York keeps possession. Now we've seen some defensive wizards among the NBA's freshman class this season. The rookie steal leader.
Let's go, hustle up.
Letting one guy look like a world.
All right, next weekend there will be no next Sunday there will be no catchism around the SummerSlam. So, there'll be no afternoon or nightcast, because I don't know what time we're leaving Sunday afternoon, and then won't be getting back till late, so.
You are the caretaker of your team, and caretaker implies many things.
We had to have a breakdown, that was on my guy! I still was able to fucking pick it up.
And then the jobs of everybody else.
And did a decent job trying to stop him.
Make everybody feel good. So if your power forward hasn't touched the ball in six or seven trips and he's a main scorer, you find that the position forces you.
That's it again.
A noticeable advantage in terms of aggression and controlling the backcourt.
And he gets it to go.
You know, you'd be hard pressed to find many players in the league that are as strong in the mid range as Melo.
Ibaka outside. Here's Young from the arc. And again, it's the man.
Yeah.
And they're getting their points now almost exclusively from the triple. Four of their last five makes are from beyond the arc.
Rose against Young. Outside Rose. Outside Anthony. Fires for three. And it's Anthony again missing.
The shooting numbers just aren't there yet in the quarter.
And Fournier picks to Prez. Back to Fournier. Six to shoot. It's Young on the wing. And again, it's...
Yeah.
He is on.
It's wide open, man.
Porzingis inside, defended by Ibaka. Porzingis with a screen on Young. Rose hits it to Noah. Goes up the baseline. That's short off the rim. Orlando leading by six. Pass to Ibaka. Here's Prez.
Yeah.
dunk. He won't miss many of those.
And you can just see him psyching himself up after a play like that. Nice slam by Fred.
And on a team full of rookies like this one, the play
ghosted. What's it? Again, ghosting.
Up their momentum.
I mean, they're going to feel it. I know Prez has been feeling it for a bit, and it's not something that you can just get over quickly. You have to have a health plan and stick to it to overcome that dip in production.
And that one gives them a plus five rebound advantage. Kevin. His first shot coming late, and the shot is
good.
His first points of the night.
You know, and that was a nice find by KP. Saw the open man. He was on time, on target with the pass. Perfect.
Pass to Ibaka. And Fournier kicks to Ibaka. At the elbow, Prez.
Oh, come on. There was a foul there. Plus, it should have went in. Again, bullcrap.
And it's Rose missing. Magic leading by four. Here's Prez. He's coming off a 16-point game against...
Yeah.
You have to consider how great he was at challenging the defense and opening up space for his teammates.
And stolen by Fournier.
You know, I know that he can make the perimeter jump shot, but I really like it when Porzingis is taking it inside and making it.
Yeah, mine gets...
Orlando's gone 7 of 11 from deep tonight, using the three-pointer to their advantage. And so, in the game for the Magic, Ibaka is the forward, Vucevic in the middle. Young is out there with Evan Fournier, and it's Prince in at the small forward position. No coverage that time.
Yeah.
Bucket of the night.
Yeah, such a sweet three-point stroke there. It can really open things up inside because as good as he shoots it, it forces the opposing big to have to step out on the perimeter.
Here's Rose.
Eck.
For the contact right there.
And the one thing about Rose is that, you know, he can still get up for the big matchups. Whenever he faces another great point guard, he seems to play at his best level and loves to push himself and is willing to step up to the challenge. Let's just hope that he can eventually get back to that all-star caliber presence he had just a few years ago.
And New York making
it. I think sort of the problem is, again, is that he's become, his players are just, you can see it. Is that worry?
And how incredible
is
the development of the Orange Juice tandem? Two rookies just setting the league alight with their incredible play.
And the most jaw-dropping thing for me.
I'm sorry, the fucking hurt. And then you go in the left hand, does get hurt. Even though that shot looks like it was a wincing.
Well, after the long speculation of
it's like it was hurting. And that play.
Is going to be on the menu for a long time, it seems. And thank goodness for that.
And what a relief it must be for both Young and Prez. The rumors have been a distraction for the team for a while, but now they can put it behind them and move on into a very bright week.
On the sideline, let's catch up with...
I don't get that rumors either.
Well, Prez in their last game against the Heat made
all... Yeah.
He ended with 16 points, and as he always seems to do, piled up rebound after rebound. That was just the latest in a solid string of performances from him. Obviously looking to keep the momentum going here this evening. We'll see how he does, Kevin.
Great job, Dave. Thank you, guys. It's going to be... We can stay in a role like that tonight.
Yeah, I mean, sometimes those hot streaks can last for days. And I'm sure they'll be feeding him the basketball, hoping he's still got that mojo working.
Well, we know by himself he can win a game for you. He has that kind of talent when he's at full capacity. Right?
And going back to when you were growing up, Doris.
And the foul. Draw the foul, at least. Can take it to the basket. They draw the foul.
Make the people around him feel great about playing the game and just for this smile on his face. You know, we all love and are passionate about the NBA and playing the game of basketball. And so he was a guy I really loved.
Well, no one enjoys the game more than you. I've just being around you, watching you broadcast, I know you love it. At all levels, you love the game.
If they're tipping it up, Kevin, I'd like to
You're
be there.
You're watching. That's right.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
Knicks trail by 11. The shot. Porzingis can't hit.
That's one he knows he should have drained.
Kicks it to Vucevic. Here's Prez. He's got 9. Young passes it to Prez. Shot clock at 6. And Young with the best.
Yeah. Is that LJ, baby?
I love the energy, fellas. I really do. But now we got to keep it up and stay focused. Just keep squeezing that orange juice, gentlemen.
It's squeezing it.
Games. He's averaging 10 points a game, 2 assists, and 2 rebounds. And he's really been pulling his weight. He's had a hand in some big plays here recently.
The Knicks have gone 3 of 8 from the field since the beginning of the second quarter. Porzingis sets the pick for Rhodes. And it's going to be out of bounds. The magical.
Wow.
And here's the 2K leaderboard with the team.
I didn't see what happened there. That guy knocked his hand and went off his own. Rough for him too. Okay.
Physical and playing with a ton of energy.
Ibaka right side. Now Prez.